Oh, I'm sorry. We were just in the middle of porn there, chanting. Anyway.
Porn chanting?
You bastard.
4chan, yes. Welcome to part 6 of Abe's Oddysee. In this, we're going to finish off Paramonia.
Hooray.
Cool.
Oh, God.
Hello!
What are you doing in my house?
It's like, ah, come on in.
Don't go any farther or he'll kill you.
Yeah, I would assume so.
Like, hey, you want to see my pet scrap?
I thought he was your roommate.
He's my roommate and my pet.
Yeah, you're fucked, aren't you?
No, it's such a, you're actually supposed to do that.
You have to distract them.
Yeah, you can't go up that way, so you have to go. So you have to go down here.
Dope.
Well, paramites don't seem to be too
aggressive.
They don't seem to care that you're around. Yeah, paramites are pretty docile until you corner them.
They're cool.
Shut up, you two. Blow bombs with spirit rings, which are just conveniently above us. Talk to this guy.
Hello. Don't call.
He has a password. But if you already know the password, you can just get it off. If you already know the password, you can just get it immediately.
I was assuming that one paramite that was protecting that one little hand thing was going to give you the password.
What? Yeah. No.
Or that one
actually,
thing that the paramite.
Well, actually, yeah, you're right. Never mind.
Holy crap! That's a lot of explosions.
Yeah, that was that. Yeah, the spirit rings will detonate all bombs around you.
Sweet.
Just be sure you're not near them when it happens. By the way.
No, my God.
By the way, a little funny glitch with that. When you're actually in the falling animation of running into something, technically you're invincible.
Interesting.
Do not forget the flint talk.
Don't forget the flint. Yeah, you can easily forget one and then have to redo the entire room over again.
I'd rather not.
Yeah.
That poor guy is stranded on that.
He don't care.
How are you supposed to save him?
You don't save him.
No, the poor guy. He's stuck there forever.
I don't know why I like the way, Oh, it's like the way Abe, like, moves the rope up and down. He's like, dope.
Rope-a-dope.
Yep.
Like that. He's that freaking.
Funny thing is that. The funny thing is that every. By the way, as soon as you get up here, run. Run immediately.
From what? Oh my god.
Why?
Yeah. As soon as you get up there, run immediately or you will die.
Fuck you, Oddworld.
The devs like to be dicks, what can I say? Anyway, have you noticed that all the Mudokons are just colored green versions of Abe?
I noticed that in episode 2.
Yeah, just keep that in mind. That's the funny part.
Like, oh, he's blue. He must be important.
This room is different because they all have little trap switches everywhere. And every time you push on one.
Yep, I saw that.
Oh god.
Yeah.
Okay, now I see it. Yeah, the little
guess what you have to do?
I think I get an idea where you got to do.
Kill this guy.
There he goes.
Good enough.
And then the game decides to dick with you.
Fuck.
The game decides to dick with you at this point. And you're like, bastard. Oh shit. For your first time playing, you're gonna run into this exact problem every single time.
Fuck.
What exactly are you supposed to do?
Jump
besides
down and back
kill
up?
Yourself.
Well, you're supposed to kill them first before activating the lock, obviously.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, because they'll come down on you as soon as you try to jump over there. I'm like, oh, fuck it.
Oh, god.
Screw it, I'll do it later.
Love how that guy just teleported off screen.
Because of the head. Yeah, it does.
Just
because
of
we'll
the
load
time.
We'll do that room, like, we'll do that room last. How about that?
Yep.
Okay, I think the majority of this part is just that one room. I can't remember.
Shit.
Oh, this one's fun. I like this one.
Oh, not more wrecking balls of death.
Death and despair.
Yes.
What I didn't tell you about this is that you can actually roll off the ledge and you'll grab onto the other ledge before, so you don't even technically have to jump.
Oh, that's convenient.
Yeah. Again, just be careful. Make sure you don't get hit by the balls.
Or the bats.
Or the bats. Like that. Time your jumps.
Dope, 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 dope.
Thankfully, yeah, watch the back, the game didn't go, oh, you died 70 plus times? Well, you get the bad ending regardless. Because you suck.
No, the game won't do that.
I know, I know. I said, thankfully, the game doesn't do that.
I don't know any game that does that, actually.
I don't know.
There are games where if you die too many times, it gets you a worse ending.
I don't know.
I can't
any
think
game
one off the top of my head.
Me either.
Yeah, I can't either.
Except for maybe Castlevania 2.
By the way, doing this, you get deactivate only one bomb because you're not going to need any of the rest of them later.
Nice.
Cool.
Be careful of this dog.
Dope, dope, dope.
And immediately run as soon as you pull the switch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do not jump or you'll just kill yourself.
Why doesn't he jump over there and blow himself up?
Because it's a slog. He's retarded.
Or smart.
Also, here's the point where you're gonna see an audio glitch with this game. This is not an emulator. This is the actual game too. Huh. Every time you move to another different screen, the enemy above you follows you, regardless, and then the music starts up repeatedly, over and over and over again.
Crap.
Oh, it's acting as if like the enemy from above is like pretty much on your tail.
Shut yeah.
The hell up! What the hell was that?
Shut that the hell be... up! That's what that was.
Yeah.
Yay, one more room to go.
And it's that same room I rage quitted so I could do the other one.
Yeah, the one room where you were like, nope.
It's like, nope, I'm done, out of here. Screw it. Anyway. I think I screwed up again, but I had to cut some... This is the room I had to cut so many times just because I kept getting it wrong.
I can kind of see why.
Alright, kill this guy. Try not to kill yourself.
Yeah, I was about to say, you almost ran right into that. Twice.
I'd prefer not to get die.
And ran into that same problem again. Thanks, Greg. And I just respawn here because I'm like, oh, I'm an idiot. Just go over here. You won't be able to kill him, so... Nope. Yeah, he can activate traps too, so be careful. Oh, he's smart.
Oh, this smart, crafty little fucker.
You fucker.
Stop being smart!
Haha, I outsmarted you. Now we can get the bell song. Go over here, activate this panel, and we got the bell song. Yay.
Sweet.
Now we can go, and again, like I said, don't attempt to kill yourself with the traps. Because you can easily do that.
Yeah.
I've noticed that a couple of times in this.
Alright, in this case, lure him over, kill him.
Poor Scrap, how many times
now,
did he kill that
as soon as you
thing?
Get over here. Alright, now roll it, get the hell out. There.
And then
now you have nothing to worry about.
Except for that thing that's
still following. You still have to get rid of him, though. Alright, now just make your way back.
Abe's all like, gotta go fast.
Abe, gotta go fast, yeah. Gotta go
you
faster,
think with all the
faster,
rolling,
faster,
they
faster,
wouldn't...
Faster.
Considering rolling's your fastest mode of transportation, you'd think they would give you, like, a special rolling attack.
As if you'd think they can attack. They wouldn't be able to do that until Exodus.
Well, shouldn't rolling into things count as an attack?
No. In Exodus, you're given the ability to slap people.
Damn it! That's not much of an upgrade.
It does jack. It does jack, but it is funny when you have like you have a really mad Budokin who won't calm down, and you just slap him. He's like, okay.
It's like that Batman meme of him just slapping Robin.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's exactly like that, actually.
Merry Christmas! It's still March, damn it!
It's still November!
Merry Christmas!
Anyway,
it's Thanksgiving, you bitch!
Anyway, This room is unique in that it's the final room in the entire in all of Paramonia. This room is unique in the fact that you remember the levels in Donkey Kong Country Returns where you're completely black and you have to move everywhere. It's a gigantic chase sequence.
Holy crap!
That looks nice. Well, we've had sequences
and
like
guess
this
what?
Before.
It's pure memorization.
Oh god!
We've had dark sequences like this before.
Yeah, but this is pretty much trial and error.
Yeah, this is 100% trial and error.
Ouch.
Considering everything's dark, termites and are everywhere.
God damn it.
So how many attempts did this take you?
Not very many actually. There is the little wind tunnel that was at the beginning there.
Yeah.
You can actually use that, and it'll take you into the background so you can scope out the layout of everything before you go in.
That's nice.
Yeah, but in these parts you do have to be fast and you have to be quick or else you will die.
Aren't quick and fast the same thing?
Yes. Also, grab a piece of meat before coming in here. Or else you won't get past this room. I almost died here.
Oh, shit.
Did you just kick them?
No. They tried to pounce.
Oh. No, like, they were standing in front of the door eating that piece of meat, and then you walked through it. It looked like you kicked them.
No.
Get out of the way!
They were pouncing. It was too late. Anyway, with this room, when you see this room, you've completed Paramonia, and yeah. Booyah. Now enjoy
Sweet.
This cutscene.
Oh god, it's Medusa in the background.
The big face said I'd learned much throughout my quest. What? This handscar would help me for more dangers await. I would need its full power to complete my fate.
No, my god.
I have no idea what just happened.
We got a hand scar that will help increase our power once we get the power from Scribania. This is the same room I showed off before. Like I said, you will return. This is the place you're always going to come back to. Let's skip ahead a bit.
Man.
I love GameSpeak. I can't help but love it. I hate Scribania, by the way. Anyway, enjoy another cut. Anyway, another cutscene.
Right. Wait, so this is the last world in the game?
Nah, we got one more world after that.
I had visions of Scrabs, safe in the wild. How they were before I was a child. Now they're cut, ground, and mashed into little cakes. Scrabs destroyed for profit's sake.
Rhyming!
Yes, rhyming. Also, nature.
It also looked like you cut that cutscene off a little too soon.
Nah, that's how it normally is.
Okay.
Anyway, from this point forward, you're gonna see more competent gameplay because this is me getting more used to the gameplay now.
Hey, God, I'll be right back.
Oh yeah. Did that my first try.
Well, considering I'm doing this the entire game, I'd be more surprised if you were getting worse.
And that's again more Elam.
Right. Elam! The best thing about this game, because he's the only way you can actually physically hit things.
Yep, easy. You can't hit anything on Elam. What are you talking about?
Well, he makes you run faster.
That's all he does.
It means a
that's
lot
his only
for
purpose.
This game.
He's literally the mule in this game.
It still means a lot for Abe.
Don't be stupid and pull that lever, by the way.
You mean that?
Yes.
You just did it.
Don't be stupid while pulling it on the X. That's schmuck bait right there.
That happens a lot.
Yep. Hop over that mine, go over here, into this. Pull this lever here. That activates the little warp over there. Try not to run into the mine while you're running over there, by the way.
So many
places. You can put this for me. And make him do this.
Stop shouting for help. Oh god.
I love doing that.
Whee.
Hey. Okay. This will summon Elam. Let's go down. Try not to fall down on your way down.
I don't see Elam.
There's Elam.
Aw. Hey, little guy.
This will be the last time we see Elam, by the way.
Aw.
Alright, I'm back. What'd I miss?
You missed a scrap. You missed a scrap. Slig exploding.
Aww. Oh well.
But he's got Elam now.
We have Elam.
Hooray!
Now. This will be a last. This world will be the last time we see Elam, though.
Oh.
No.
Yeah. After we pass Scribania, we'll never see Elam again.
Ever?
Yep. For the rest of the game.
Oh. Nice. Now that I look at him, Elam looks like something straight out of freaking Star Wars. What are those things?
I forget. I know what you're talking about, but I can't think of the name.
They're riding them in, like, the snow desert.
And I had a brain fart with GameSpeak.
Whoops.
Okay. Yeah.
He gives you this one will give you spiritual rings.
Right.
Which you need for a lot of bombs. Like that one.
Oh, shit.
If you had pulled that lever, that bomb would have jet right toward you.
Oh, shit.
Ouch.
Yeah, you're going to see that a lot in this world. This world is shorter than Paramonia, but it's also a lot harder.
Okay.
And I'll show you why it's a lot harder.
Wait.
Your pack mule's dancing to your chance.
Who cares about the pack mule? Alright, as soon as we go down this level, you're gonna see why this world is a lot harder.
Why are there so many levers and pulley systems in this world?
Because Abe needs some kind of transportation. He has no cars. That's the password for later.
That's actually the password for them. Is just farting.
Yeah.
Well, they gotta use that button somehow.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, they gotta use that butt. Tin.
Gotta use that somehow. Butt. Give me that butt! God
damn it.
Give me that butt! Yeah! And this is what I was talking about.
Jeez!
Ow!
The game gets harder.
How are you supposed to do that?
Duck.
Hello. Password.
Then use the password here.
Oh, so you can duck and while still using the game speak.
Yeah, you can. And this world really encourages that.
Shit.
It's the only time I've ever seen you do that.
Yeah, you don't really need to do it after a while.
Follow me.
Maybe you did it in an earlier part and I just don't remember.
Yeah, I think I actually did. I can't remember how. Anyway, yeah. You have to use Elam, hop over here.
Oh god.
Now you have to time your running so you don't run into the bombs.
Shit. Well, thankfully, once you do it for one room, the other rooms seem to go in sync with you.
Yeah, if you go past one, you'll go in sync easily. All you have to do is make sure you jump at the right time at that point.
Yeah.
Alright, in the next part, we're going to be heading into Scribania more, and maybe into the Scribonian Temple, where we'll meet Scrabs officially for the first time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Scrabs are assholes.
Scrassholes.
Scrass, but... Sure, why not?
I don't know, smash get ball.